Larissa collapsed. The first thing that came to me was a lung. That represents the breath of man. A lot of people are going to die. He is going to take a lot of people out of here. Saints and the ain't, but it's both. Saved or not. Casual Christians become casualties. So if you're not paying attention, as Sister said, you don't know that when you turn that corner, that there was a devil waiting on you to take you out. And you will be taken out because God says, it's our responsibility. It's our responsibility to pray, to fast, to seek the Lord while he may be found. He says, it's your responsibility. He said, did I not say, work out your salvation with fear and trembling? Did I not say that, saith the Lord? Did I not say that, saith God? So it is our responsibility. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you, Jesus. There's going to be so many people close to us. We know. And you're going to hear a lot of crying in the land. I don't know how many of you were familiar with the first 10 commandments by Cecil B. DeMille when the death angel came. And you heard all of the people crying out because the firstborn were being struck down. It was just so much crying. Even at the house of Moses, the family members were saying, why is death around? What's going on? And Moses said, we are safe. We are under the blood. The blood is on the door. Just let death go by. God is allowing this because he says, I'm tired. I will not strive with man. And judgment, yes. Confirmation unto what the sister was saying. Confirmation, every last word. And those that doubt, and those that say, oh, I don't believe all that. God is like, that's fine. Because when it comes upon you, sudden destruction. Sudden destruction. You will not get away from it. Also, the collapsing. God said, he was telling me while she was talking, he says, yes, yes, daughter, that's true. The ground will open up its mouth. And Brother Roger said that he had a dream, just like you just said about you were something about opening and closing. Hell has enlarges herself. Hell has a mouth, and that's what it is. Hell is preparing. Hell is preparing itself. It's enlarging herself. Houses, whole buildings, and buildings and structures of things that you thought were going to stand. Hallelujah, are going to fall into the ground. This is all scriptural. Go to Exodus, go to Genesis. God did, and he is going to take a lot of these people that are in the way out of the way. And it's happening now as we speak. There's earthquakes every day somewhere in this world. Every day, every day, every day. There's volcanoes erupting. Every day, every day, every day, saith the Lord. And don't think that you're safe, because once you begin to think I'm safe, nothing's going to happen to me. Watch out. Sudden destruction. That's what the word of the Lord told me to say. Oh, I'm sorry, Father, thank you. He said, all of you, me too, that includes myself, you need to fast. And if you're on medication or you can't fast, God says, give me 24 hours. If you eat at 9 o'clock in the morning, don't eat till 9 o'clock the next morning. I need my body to fast. If you can go more than that, I will honor that fast, says the Lord. He said, I need all of you. He's not just talking to us online. He's talking to him, the whole body of Christ. All of our brothers and sisters all over the world are getting this message, and I feel it in my spirit. I feel so, ooh, Jesus, we need to fast. And if you can just do 24 hours, God, see how merciful he is? See how merciful he is. You can give me 24 hours, like he told the disciples. Could you not stay away for an hour? You can give God 24 hours. Yes, you can. And just like the devil came through my place the other day and knocked stuff all off and everything and tried to manifest, and I wasn't scared. The only thing was that I was irritated. And the Lord said, the reason why you weren't afraid is because you've been all up in my bosom. You've been next to me, and it didn't scare you. He said, that's what fasting and staying close to me will give you the strength. It will give you the backbone. It will give you the fortitude and the boldness to say, devil, get out of here in the name of Jesus. You can't come over here. I know what my rights are. I have a covenant with the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. And you ain't got no business around here. The blood of Jesus is all over me. Now get out of here. That's that. You can't do that if you're carnal. You can't do that, like she said, if you're all happy and, oh, I'm just going to do it. You're in the flesh. You're carnal. Mm-hmm. Your flesh is weak. Mm-hmm. This battle is a spiritual. This is a spiritual battle. You need to, like you feed your body and feed your belly, you need to feed your spirit, says the Lord. A lot of you are malnutrition. You're not going to be able to stand. You've got to do this. Portion control. Try not to eat so much. Turn the plate down. God is asking us. He's commanding us. Give me 24 hours. At least give me 24 hours, for I am merciful and I am compassionate. Give me 24 hours.
Amen. Mm-hmm. I've been praying for the natural collapse in the last few days on that island where that volcano blew up. The lava is covering houses, destroying houses. Thank God there's no loss of life yet.
Woo!
But because of it still exploding even more today, there's going to be acid rain, and they're telling people to stay in their houses in Europe, parts of Europe and Africa.
Mm.
And it's just all these, what you were saying, these weather phenomena, Hurricane Ida, they've never seen nothing like it on the earth. All the weather experts, never seen nothing like that on the earth, where it went all the way up into New York. And when it got to Louisiana, a Category 4, and that never happens.
Wow.
It always decreases when it hits land.
Wow.
This one just hung out for 10 hours.
Woo!
Stayed at a Category 4.
Mm.
Stayed there and stayed and stayed. Never happened.
Wow.
And he was barking on the plane, on the airplane like a dog because they told him to put on a mask.
Woo!
People fighting on planes because they have to put on a mask. Fight breaking out like Pat said, all in weird places. Families killing each other. Just demonic stuff is
right.
Going on.
Right.
And yes, we got to stay under his bosom.
Yes.
Like never before.
Right.
And I thank you, Lord, for that word, that warning, that watchwoman watching over us. Thank you, Pat. Blessings to that word and all of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
As we leave the sanctuary, as we go our separate ways, may God's favor rest upon thee. May he cover you with his grace. Whoa. I'll be praying for you. Whoa. Please keep praying for me. Yeah. May God keep us all in the palm of his hands, till we're together again. Together again. Till we're together again. Together again.